All right, ladies and gentlemen, our first team for the 2014 championship game is the Coast Guard, started by Captain Kyle McMahon.
Kyle's had a heck of a tournament so far. He's looking to add to the home run chase. It looks currently that he is tied for the lead with David Prate with one game to go.
Next up is Timothy Healy, who caught a flight home at the last second from Mexico.
You know what they say about catching late-night flights from Mexico?
No, what do they say, Ryan?
I don't know. That's where you were supposed to come in.
Our third player from Coast Guard is Andrew Hartner, all the way from the Mile High City. Do you know what the Mile High City is?
That would be Denver, Colorado, Chris.
That's way off.
Finally, we have the dog himself, Nathan Johansson.
Nate is playing in his second consecutive championship game. Let's see if he can bring home the hardware one more time.
That's exciting. Finally, we have the Army with the captain of captains, Richard Vandenboom.
Rick still chasing that elusive Tournament of Champions title. It's a feel-good story anytime he's playing the championship game.
We also have a very, very constant presence in the championship game and the strikeout trophy. One of the past winners, Ryan Haverland.
He is married to a former Miss Wiffle Ball, so he definitely has the pedigree.
We also have another veteran in Jeff Azuri coming to the field.
Yep, Jeff had to take a year off last year, but he's back and he is excited to play.
We also have one of our young guns. Everyone knows him. He's Eric Grzynski.
We call him G-Money here in Lake Orion Wiffle Ball. He's even keeled, but he can be deadly.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, those are your two championship teams. Let's give them a round of applause. So the way the championship, or the way the tournament ran, Rick's team, the Army, will be the home team. So we'll have the Coast Guard starting off the first inning.
Now our field is a bit of a tricky situation. We have land and sea. I'm going to say that the Army's going to excel a little bit better on land, but the Coast Guard definitely will be playing it into the water a lot.
Well, thank God we don't have any lefties playing this year because...
Oh, thank God for that.
I guess I could go without saying.
All right, we're waiting for the first pitch, and the home plate umpire, David Freight and Jim Vandenboom.
Looks like Army is setting up with Rick Vandenboom at pitcher, Eric Grzynski at shortstop, Jeff Azuri will be playing left field, and Ryan Haverland at center. Eric Grzynski, or Kyle McMahon, to start batting for the Coast Guard.
All right, we're ready for the first pitch, Chris. The 2014 Wiffle Ball is about to start.
Started off with the ball.
Well, there's a couple ways to pitch him, and neither of them are good options.
I hear hitting the plate doesn't result in a strike usually.
Is that true? That's very, very true.
It's interesting that he tried that twice in a row.
All right, we had a weak ground ball up the middle, and it was misplayed. We got runners on first. It's a good start for Team Coast Guard.
Let's see what the official scores. It looks like they're calling that a hit, Ryan.
Uh-oh. That's the home run ball.
Hey, keep going. Right now. Coast Guard jumps out to a quick 2-0 lead. Can Rick recover? He's doing a classic forward spin pitch. I don't really know if it's going to work for Mr. Healy. Oh, he's hitting the plate again. I'd like to thank Clayton Catering for bringing Jell-O shots all the way up to the sky deck here. This is amazing.
2,000 Jell-O shots for this event. It's amazing.
Everybody in the arena has a jelly shot. Jell-O.
It happens, Chris. All right, Rick with the windup. Drew with a big cut.
Is it just me, or I see a little Dennis Eckersley in? Oh, no, no, he's lefty. So.
He is going with the belly, what do they call those things? Tube top and mohawk combo today. That's our first strikeout of the day, folks. Why did that?
Oh boy, we had our first ridiculous smack of the day from Kyle McMahon. That's a two-run homer, ladies and gentlemen.
Kyle McMahon is well ahead of the pack now for the Home Run King Trophy with his eighth of the day.
Eight home runs.
You know, there's just not a good way to pitch him, Chris. I actually had the displeasure of pitching against him in two separate games. I think he accounted for six of those were against me. So, and I think that's the only home run up I gave up all day. It's embarrassing for me to talk about.
Yeah, sounds like you're a terrible pitcher, too.
You know? It hurts.
Nathan Dog Johansson up at the plate. He's always worn the number 2-5.
Ooh. Heavy with a silky smooth play up the middle.
Way to go, Ryan. You know, Rick looks really free out there. He doesn't look inhibited by that top at all.
He looks like he's getting frustrated at the home plate umpire, but it was clearly low.
Speaking of a home plate umpire, we have David Prate behind home plate, who is the head umpire this year. He hasn't got a single call wrong this tournament. It's amazing.
It's incredible, especially with the field we have. We got the Plinko tree. It's a Japanese red maple imported from Japan. It's 700 years old. Just a little fun fact for you for Vandenboom Field.
Just a bit
inside.
You and me, we finish each other's sentences.
Oh, and Rick Vandenboom with a gift from the stairs from the hostess.
There you go, Colin.
Rick, how many restaurants? That concludes the top of the first inning with four quick runs. Let's see if the home team can get those back in the bottom. First at bat out by Rick Vandenboom. That was pretty close to almost clearing the roof, Ryan.
Eric Gerzinski is sitting on one home run for the day. That is very un-G-Money-like. Former home run trophy champion, two-time.
How many strikeouts does he have this year?
He's got one and one and an E1.
He starts it off with a quick single. Umpire David Prate unhappy with the base running.
Now, Nate Johansson, this is his second time pitching the final game. He's known for his elaborate leg kick and sometimes exaggerated throwing motions.
Now, do you think pitching in a final game is an advantage, or do you think the nerves are still getting to him out there?
He looks pretty relaxed, but, you know, I know if I was out there, I'd be very, very tense.
We got Deborah Clayton out in the audience telling us to turn the microphone up. Apparently, she can't quite hear us all the way up in the skybox.
Well, your mother is getting up in age, Chris, so you got to cut her some slack. She apparently heard that one. She sent me some sort of hand signal I couldn't see.
Can we get a second opinion from Ron? Ron, can you hear us out in right field? Ron, can we get a thumbs up or a thumbs down? It looks like they're...
Fair ball. It looks like Rick is arguing with all the umpires. I don't know what the ejection break call. Let the umpires do their job, folks.
Now, Rick showed up from Alaska with quite a mullet. Now, he shaved the sides. He said he wanted to be a little bit more aerodynamic. But, Ryan, I'm looking at that physique, and I really don't know if that's going to help.
Well, I agree, Chris, but he's got that buddy glove, which will help your aerodynamics by 0.002%, so they say that stuff works.
I hear that's what Michael Phelps wore when he raced for the championship gold in the Olympics.
Absolutely.
Oh, Nate, good hustle, dude!
All right, the head umpire says he needs a refill, and you know what, Chris? I'm getting a little low, too.
So, are you leaving here, me here by myself?
No, Chris. I was hoping that one of the lovely ladies in bikinis would be so kind to get the co-host of this event and the head umpire.
Thank God, because I'm terrified of being left alone.
Oh, that's why they didn't come. They're coming in from a boat.
Oh, look at this. The first one is a lefty.
Oh.
What does that say about all the other girls in bikinis here? Chris Sweeney.
All right. If you can see the boat that just came through, that is Tim Hollis of Full Out Audio. The reason we sound so good right now, Chris, is because he was generous enough to donate those beautiful wireless speakers that we've been rocking all morning and afternoon long. Tim, with an amazing play, it looks like he was safe at the first. Let's look to see what the umpires say.
It seems like a controversial call from home plate umpire Dave Prate. He's calling everybody safe.
Hey, I'm not the ump. Jeff.
It's nice not to intercede in these sorts of arguments. Even though we have an excellent view from the skybox,
well, Chris, you know me. It's kind of hard for me to keep my mouth shut sometimes, so you got to remind me. Thank you.
Now, you were a former player, is that correct?
As of 35 minutes ago, I was actually a former player in the tournament, yes.
Now, you have some special insight to being a player on the field. Can you tell us what these two teams are going through right now?
Well, you know, I'd much rather be in their shoes, or non-shoes, because shoes are not allowed. But, yeah, I'd do anything to be out there right now, Chris. But they are into the game and focused.
Can we get a mic check? Can you hear me? Can you hear me in right field?
Oh, did somebody just give me
that? If you hear me in right field, say hey.
Hey, Army, right?
If you hear me in left field, say ho. That sounds like it came from right field, actually. So you can't obviously hear me at all.
Well, you know, Chris, sometimes with our field, who knows left, right? I mean, all I know is left is bad.
Well, if you look at the tournament this year, there's not a single lefty in the championship game. So, Ryan, what does that tell you?
Well, you know, it's hard to get down on Dave Welch too much for being left-handed because he did have a heck of a tournament in a losing cause. But, I mean, it just shows that right-handed is the better hand.
May I interject and just tell everybody that Jeff Azzurri just hit a bases-clearing double. That is a monumental feat in the championship game. It looks like it's 5-4 home team in the bottom of the first. We haven't had a high-scoring championship game like this in a while.
Oh, Ryan Hammerlin hits it off the porch. If it stays up, it's a ground rule double. Jeff Zuri's coming home calm, cool, and collected.
You know, Ryan, it's nice to see that out of a former Mr. Wiffleball. As everybody here knows, Megan Haverlin was last year's Miss Wiffleball.
Rick hits it to... Oh, and a boot, and he looks like... Oh. Well, I don't think he got him either way, folks. But you know what, Chris? You know, it's just great to be here with everybody out in the grandstands supporting a great cause. We're looking to raise money for veterans. We're donating to 3 different organizations. Wins for Warriors, Justin Verlander. He's going to be matching our donation to his charity. We've got the Orion Veterans Memorial, our local, beautiful Veterans Memorial that, excuse me, I get choked up thinking about our vets.
It's okay.
And then we've got the Desert Angels, which sends care packages overseas.
Now that is something.
Now, Chris, a strong north by northwest breeze just came in. That changes things quite a bit.
You can see Nate can't even hit the plate. He's thrown about 6 straight balls, Ryan.
I don't know. His throwing motion just doesn't seem as smooth and as fluid as he's normally.
You know, he's been pitching the entire tournament. Oh, you can tell he's he's starting to get a little worn out.
There's Eric Grzinski with the slow walk.
There's a 3-run home run shot.
I wouldn't be surprised if he gets thrown high and inside next at bat.
It looks like the scoreboard is malfunctioning. We can't get a total score on the right-hand side. It looks like the scoreboard attendant is throwing gang signs. I can't quite tell what the final score is. Oh, looks like it's finally coming in there. Looks like it's 9-4.
Okay. We got to...
Oh, a quick, easy play by Nate. You know, that's his natural position, is shortstop.
I actually heard it was left out. Heads up play by the pitcher. That is the final out of the inning. And ladies and gentlemen, quite a first inning we had.
I haven't seen runs like this in the first inning. Normally, everybody gets a little... exhausted with all this wiffle ball, so a very exciting first inning, that's for sure.
It's nice to see. I believe the final from last year was 2-1. 2-1.
That is not correct. It was 2-1 going to the bottom of the 6th inning, and Mikey Kleeman hit a 3-run walk-off home run to win the tournament.
Michael Kleeman, I'd love to have him up in the skybox. If Michael is out there, we'd love to hear about it.
Well, he's busy, Chris. He's working the first base and right field line as an umpire.
Now that's dedication, Ryan. A big win coming from the backstop. Can Rick make it to the plate this time? Another weak single to shortstop. Quick out.
Well, it's always nice to get a quick two outs. You don't want to get your pitch count too high. Ooh, foul ball.
Now, Ryan, what exactly are the rules with changing pitchers out?
Well, Chris, you can't change pitchers and have them re-enter within the same inning, but they can actually re-enter later in the game. It's not like your normal baseball rules. Oh, the Plinko tree, bing bong, hits it onto the deck for a base hit.
I'm sure all our viewers at home can see the gigantic Japanese maple tree in the middle of left center field.
Yes, we call it the Plinko tree because, like the beautiful Price is Right game, it goes boop, boop. It's very, very hilarious. You don't know what's going to happen when it goes on that Japanese maple.
I saw the pitcher shaking his hand a little bit. Do you think he's a little tired out, a little sore from the day's festivities?
Just a hair outside on that one. Tim Healy with a good, strong cut.
The great thing about Rick Vandenboom at pitcher is he never uses the same arm slot. He goes from sidearm to lefty.
Yes, he does, Chris. Looks like they're running the base pass. Oh, that's a ground rule double.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, it landed up in the upper quadrant platform, what we like to call the
second
floor balcony. It's an automatic ground rule double.
Yeah, yes, for you viewers watching at home, we call that the grandstand deck up there.
Drew Hartner at the plate. He is our lengthiest contestant in wiffle ball history. I believe he's 7 feet 2 inches tall. He uses a 6-foot wiffle bat, ladies and gentlemen. It looks like it's 2 feet tall. Nathan Johansson just crossed home plate and he said something towards the skybox. I don't think he realizes we can't hear him up here. After a 4-run first inning, Coast Guard was only able to score 0 runs that time. It looks like a fair ball, and it cleared the house, ladies and gentlemen.
That is Rick Vandenboom's 4th home run. Oh, it looks like we're running low on wiffle balls, so...
Right, look at them all.
All right, Jim just got all of them right in between that comment.
Got Jim.
Oh, a hard hit ball into the Plinko tree. Oh, and it drops for a base hit. G-Money calmly sits down at one. Oh, we got a bloop into the water, and that's a single ground rule single. Only in Lake Orion wiffle ball is a ground rule single, Chris.
Now, why exactly, if you hit it in the water in right field, is it a ground rule single, Ryan?
Well, Chris, many moons ago when we were writing the bylaws of wiffle ball at Lake Orion Wiffle Ball Association, we decided to discriminate against left-handed people, and therefore we made it a ground rule single.
Now, I'd love it if we could get a lefty up in the skybox. I believe the only lefty this year is David Welch. If we could get an interview with David, that would be fantastic.
Absolutely. In between this inning, we'll have a sit-down interview with the one and only David Welch, our favorite and least favorite lefty.
Well, that goes without saying. Ryan Haverland up at plate.
And
with a rope out to
left field. It looks like G-Money is going. Oh! Kyle McMahon calmly covering home plate. A fortunate bounce back into play. That could have been a ground. An extra 2 bases there, folks. very patient with the pitch. And everybody, we'd like to give a shout out to our Oakland County Sheriff for keeping our waters safe. Thank you, Sheriff. Rick's just patiently waiting for a pitch. Hits a hard.
You know, Ryan, Rick is a shining example of. These colors really don't run, do they?
Absolutely not, Chris.
Otherwise.
At least not as quick as they used to.
Otherwise, they would have made it to first.
Eric Grzynski hails from Royal Oak, Michigan, and is a proud graduate of Notre Dame Prep. Oh, we had a double. Oh, that ball's out. That's an extra two bases. G-Money goes to third.
Eric would never move past first before the ball went out.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a very frequent sight in the Lake Orion Wiffle Ball Tournament. They're discussing the rules. Two runs scored.
And it looks clarified. We got two runs in on that play. In the championship game, they just want to make sure they have the right call.
Am I seeing that correctly? Is that 13-4 in the championship game? The away team has some work to do. Another base hit and another run, Ryan. I don't know if they can stop this bleeding.
I have not seen an offensive output like this in a long time.
Do you think they should bring in the tourniquet team Healy at pitcher?
Well, that would be a risky, very risk-reward move because he has never pitched in Lake Orion Wiffle Ball. Oh, but if this goes over, folks, I think they got to make a switch. What an amazing tournament by Ryan Haverland. Oh, with a great, graceful slide into home, Ryan Haverland. That might be most hustle material right there, folks.
Let's take a look at that replay. All you kids out there. Take note, that is exactly not
and how it's to a slide. It's official inside the park home run for Ryan, Mr. Wiffleball Haverland. Well, it's a hard hit ball that goes over the roof, and as you can see, normally that's a home run, but it stayed in somehow. We didn't have somehow camera 9 got cut out in the back corner.
And normally when you slide, you don't want to leave your arm in right underneath you like that, but to each his own, Ryan, to each his own.
Yep. Oh, it looks like the home plate umpire is going down to first to see if he went.
Now, Rick looked at that bat like there was a hole in it. Do they make holy bats?
Hold on, we've got a guy power washing in right field. That could be an issue, folks. If it hits him, it's a home or a ground rule single, depending on the flagpole.
Ryan, are you usually supposed to carry the wiffle ball bat all the way to first base?
It's a player's preference, but you can go to one. Sometimes guys get carried away. This one looks like it's pushed to the right, and that's going to be a ground rule single.
That has got to be the longest single I have ever seen.
Yeah. Well, that fan's got a wonderful souvenir. That doesn't happen very often. Oh, it looks like he's throwing it back. He must be rooting for the Coast Guard. Oh, he's throwing it back. He doesn't want that ball.
He's a little furious.
He doesn't turn down for anything, that guy.
Hey,
Is that a 40 horsepower back there? It looks like it's struggling a little bit. Oh, that's a Buddha E6 by Dog25.
An easy play biffed by the third baseman. Nate, Dog25, you don't see that too often.
Well, it's happened, looks like, one or two times this game. Oh, we got a bloop shot. Can they see it? Oh, that could.
Oh. He redeems himself with an easy pop-up catch.
Well, no damage done there, but, you know, sometimes those errors can turn into runs. And
now, Ryan, we have a very special guest in the booth right now. We have David Welch. He is actually the only currently existing left-hand player in the Lake Orion Wiffleball Association.
Dave, thanks for joining us.
You're welcome.
Now, Dave, how hard is it to play in this sort of association where you're not respected, everybody hates you, and, you know?
It's pretty much kind of like everyday life. Because I am left-handed, no one really likes me all that much. No one respects me, for sure. So I just come out here and try and play the best whip ball I can.
Now, I understand you're a butcher for Hollywood Meat.
That is correct.
How many people get upset with you because you can't exactly cut meat properly with your left hand?
What you don't realize is I cut meat right-handed. Oh, so you can take that left-handed meat cutter joke and...
So, I guess a follow-up question, how does it feel to be living a lie on a 24-hour basis?
It just goes back to the no respect thing. It's just kind of what life is for a lefty these days.
Now, Dave, if you don't mind me asking, tell us a little bit about your mustache that you had here. You entered yourself into the best mustache competition, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, I did. I was going for a 3-in-a-row championship with the mustache, and unfortunately came up a little short to Kevin Clayton.
Tell us a little bit about that mustache.
Yeah, nobody really likes a bragger, by the way.
Oh, that was right in the pills. That hurt a little bit watching. What I did with the mustache was going to try and spell vets out, and I may have screwed up the T and kind of looked like V's.
Oh, so maybe the judges were confused that you were spelling V's instead of vets or something?
I think that had something to do with it.
Now, do you think your left-handedness had anything to do with you messing your face up like that?
Oddly enough, I also shaved right-handed.
That's another story for another day. Dave Welch, thanks for joining us.
We'd like to thank you, Dave.
And also, Dave Welch is of the Hollywood Market family. They were the generous sponsor of the food for last night's draft night charity dinner. So they do a great thing supporting our veterans. So we're glad to have you, even though you're left-handed. Thank you, Dave.
You know, they are the meat people. So if you guys want a good cut of meat to barbecue on this, you know, lovely summer day, you might as well go to Hollywood Market.
Absolutely, Chris. That's where my beautiful fiance Leah gets all of our groceries.
A beautiful double play, just flawless.
Just a very smooth, easy delivery from the hands to the throwing hand. Just beautiful.
You know, you'd only expect that from a right-hander, Ryan.
That's why they don't play shortstop normally.
Drew Lankstad-Hartner, again, all the way from Denver, Colorado. Do you think the altitude difference is really messing with his swing right now?
I think also that he's higher up generally, that he's at a higher altitude from his lengthiness.
It's really weird to see a right-hander hit it to right field. Do you think Dave Welch has gotten into length that a little bit?
Well, you know, I think Rick's bringing it in pretty quick. That one topped out at 6.0 miles per hour. That's the maximum speed for Lake Orion Wiffleball, so I think he was just a little late to the party on that swing.
Yeah. Rick is known for throwing the fastballs on a regular basis. He routinely tops out 6.0 and sometimes 6.1 without the umpire's notice.
Well, we have an issue with speed sometimes where people throw a little too rambunctiously, so that's why for this game we have the actual heat umpires, what we call it. Just a little bit above the letters there, folks. It's into the hostas. Oh.
we would appreciate it if players on the field would let the umpires make the calls.
I got him. Okay.
It looks like Mikey Kleeman called Drew safe at second. It was close.
From the booth, it looked like his lengthy hand reached the bag just in time.
Mikey Kleeman is giving me a fingernail. Is that? Yes, he's nodding. It's a fingernail distance.
The breeze is picking up. I mean, the wind can shift and it just changes everything. It's amazing.
Nate caught looking at the first strike.
Nate, don't let it go by.
Oh, a dead rope up to mid-center field. It looks like Jeff Azzurri. Oh, with a decent cutoff, but that gets a run in.
Double scores one.
Let's go, Timmy.
That makes the bleeding stop at 16 to...
Our scoreboard officiating is struggling a little bit over there. I'm not sure if he is right-handed, left-handed, or...
It looks like a six.
That's right.
I don't know. It it
six it, triangle. It, he's trying shapes over. I can't tell. Try. Yeah.
And Tim Healy with the big ol' whiffa.
All right, and we haven't given that wonderful shout-out for Vandenboom Field and the first family of Wiffle Ball, Rick and Kathy Vandenboom. Thank you for letting us tear up your grass another year. We've got some more Wiffle Ball to go, though, so let's have some good hustle. They make it all happen, folks. Soft ground ball for now.
You can't hear anything.
This guy sucks.
I wanted to play that one.
Well, let's turn this off and just have that call.
It's like I'm really there.
A slap out to left field, but that is a single since it's off the siding.
In play off the siding of the house.
You know, Ryan, that's a new rule this year. Usually if you caught it off the siding, it was an out. This year, it's in play.
Yeah, we've made a lot of adjustments to the rules. The field has changed. We've got a two-person hot tub on the deck now, so that changes things. The deck has changed. We've had railing issues, upgrades. So
quick interjection. Azzurri strikes out to end the inning. We have a 16-6 ball game going into the bottom of the third. Top of the fourth.
I do.
Drew's getting a little aggressive in the plate there.
It's at bottom of the third. I was correct.
Oh, that's a shot up the center. Looks like a good hustle and relay by Ryan Haverlin holds him to one.
It's a pretty long single, Ryan. Usually a little bit of hustle would have gotten you to second there.
I think he's still a little tired from that inside the park home run, to be honest with you, Chris.
You know,
oh, that was
Kyle cannot be happy about that bloop out to third base. Shaking his head, sitting in the dugout, ashamed of himself. I actually can't even talk right now.
That's a warning from the home plate umpire. He should not.
It looks like the home plate ump is trying to talk to us all the way from behind home plate. We have no idea what he said, but it looks like we may have been wrong.
They were gesturing for each other. He got a big rip, but he got just a tip.
Steve Cullen just filled us into the fact that Nate Johansson is without a home run this year.
Perfect time for it, but you know what? If you hit base hits.
Let's check the
well, the official score sheet could never be wrong at all, possibly. So no, he's zero.
It does look like he has a strikeout though, Ryan.
Yeah, those jump up and bite you sometimes.
I believe they call that a minus one in the biz.
Absolutely.
Now Tim Healy at bat, as I'm sure most of the audience has noted, he's not wearing the official uniform of the rest of his team. He is such a loner that he said no. He said no. I want to be my own man.
Well, he's wearing his Hustle shirt, Chris.
Yeah.
That's why.
Again, Dave Prate trying to talk to the skybox from behind home plate. We cannot hear you, Dave.
It's deadly quiet. Oh! We are going to have to look at that at instant replay. It looked like he might have trapped it. He should have hustled back to the center circle, but... Going to the bottom of the fourth. 16-6, bottom of the fourth. They are trying to pad their lead. Quick out. One pitch, one out. That's the way to do it. He's pitched a few innings, so he's getting a little tired out there. You can tell.
Now, our next batter, Rick Vandenboom, is in from Alaska. Is that correct?
Absolutely. The beautiful last frontier. Looks like he's got a foul ball. Will it stay up? But it goes over the big house.
Now, he flew in all the way from Alaska last week. Is that right?
Well, just to clarify, Chris, he actually took an airplane. Rick cannot actually fly, but I think he actually made a connecting flight in Chicago O'Hare. That airport is just a complete nightmare for all you folks at home. I think you know what I'm talking about.
Now, Rick is a perennial runner-up for the home run trophy. How many does he have this year?
Well, you know, I think he's being restricted by that body glove thing, but it is three home runs for him. But, you know, the most important thing is bringing home the hardware, that elusive championship trophy.
Now, again, do you think the altitude difference in Alaska is... Oh, we got a shot to left field for a...
Oh, he is disregarding the first base coach's sign to hold. He just barrels into second with a beautiful hustle play.
Now, sometimes you can just see a veteran by his base running. That was a veteran base running move.
Eric Rosinski adds to the lead, folks. This is getting out of hand.
Now that makes the score 18-6. I'm no mathematician, Ryan, but I believe that's at least double of what the other team has right now.
Yes, it is. I need to get my TI 83 plus out, but I think that's correct.
You go. Whoa, what a play.
Now was that an actual at bat or was he just giving the pitcher the ball back?
I'm very confused. Oh, Nate with a quick hot shot catch.
Now, it seems like Army might want to try not hitting it to the other fielders. It looks like the last two at-bats they hit it directly to the other team. You might not want to do that usually, right, Ryan?
Well, they are down to their final three outs, Chris. This has been a pretty quick side for the Army. They really need to get something going here. Oh, Drew Hartner into the hostas. And off the Plinko tree.
Length Dad stretches out a single.
Kyle McMahon.
Hey, Bob.
Leading the home run count. count. Can he add to this tally and get his team a little bit closer?
Now, Ryan, I'm no expert, but that looked like he was purposely aiming for the head there.
Flickering wiffle ball takes their head injuries very seriously. He's going to have a medical staff in between this inning to make sure that he's okay.
Now, we saw Chad Elliott take quite a hit earlier. Was he concussion tested?
Absolutely. The results did not come back well. It looked like there was some previous brain damage before, though, so we think he might be in intensive care right now. We're not sure. And it looks like we got one down. They are, Rick Vandenboom is one more out closer to, oh, does he double up to end the championship? Rick Vandenboom ends the game with a double play.
Lake Orion, oh. Wiffle Ball Association Tournament.
Oh my gosh. The team representing a branch of our military, the Armed Forces, wins the 2014 trophy. You know, it always feels good. This is Rick's first championship. You gotta feel good for the guy right now.
Now, Ryan, what does a championship feel like?
Well, Chris, I'm gonna have to defer that question to you because I have not won yet.
That's right, I have won and you haven't.
That is also correct, Chris. But, you know, I would gladly strike out 27 times if I could bring home the hardware. Now, before, there was somebody that actually struck out an amazing 26 times. Well, to fill you folks in at home, you are sitting next to the one and only Chris Clayton from the Chris Clayton Strikeout Trophy. But he does have the hardware, so
now
I am jealous.
Speaking of, we might as well get right out and start giving these awards away. Who does it look like won the Chris Clayton Strikeout Trophy? I'm sure they couldn't have quite hit 26 strikeouts, but...
Well, it looks like we've got two guys sitting at five. Let's move.
Oh, three.
We have the first three-way tie. So we're going to tally up the home runs and the strikeouts, and the three co-commissioners and a couple other guys are going to rally around and figure out best play, and then we're going to get right into the presentation of the championship trophy after those awards.
Hello, I'm Oakland County Sheriff Mike Bouchard.
And I'm former Detroit Red Wing Joe Koester.
We'd like to remind you to practice safe boating by knowing the laws regarding water safety.
Please make sure you have the necessary safety equipment on board and be sure all of your equipment is working properly before leaving the dock.
And the probability of being involved in a boating accident nearly doubles when alcohol is involved. Always check local weather conditions, and if you notice darkening clouds, play it safe. Get off the water. Have a safe, enjoyable summer on the lake.
All right, so we got a couple awards to give out. The first and one of the most prestigious is the Chris Clayton Strikeout Trophy. Now, Chris, do we have the final tallies for that? Chris, who are the three lucky winners of this beautiful and manly Chris Clayton Trophy?
You know, I'm really, really proud of this, Ryan. Brings a tear to my eye every time I get to give this away. Actually, we do have three winners this year. The first is Mr. Christopher Sweeney. We also have Jay Crate.
Congratulations. Hey, thank you. Took a lot of hard work.
And this next one is actually really close to home. He's not here right now, but my brother. Oh, he is? Steve Clayton?
Steve
Clayton is also the third winner.
We get to share it.
Now, they just did a quick Twitter poll back home
for our viewers at Orion Network Television. Apparently, people are getting sick of hearing my voice, so I'm going to hand this off to Jim Vandenboom to give out the rest of the awards. One of the co-commissioners, Jim Vandenboom.
Thanks, guys. And I couldn't agree more with Ryan and what's the next one up?
The home run piece.
Next one up is home run.
I'll take it, man.
Kyle McMahon.
It was a tight race going into the finals, but it turns out number 25, Kyle McMahon.
Yes, sir!
Kyle McMahon had an amazing tournament. I had the displeasure of having to pitch against him two separate games. Great game, Kyle. Great tournament. We're very happy to have you here. How does it feel to win your first Home Run King championship? It feels great. Redact that. That was not a championship. It's just a trophy.
You just hurt my feelings again.
Oh. Thanks, Kyle.
Yeah, no.
Hey, stay up here.
There you go.
Next up, we have the Most Hustle Award. This one awarded to those that may not have made the best play, but that exerted the most effort throughout the tournament. But this one this year actually goes to co-commissioner Ryan Skalnick. For both his diving plinko ball catch. Which is pretty darn good. Ryan, how did you feel about those catches?
Well, the technical play that actually won was the plinko tree, but I actually was more proud of my tippy-toe backstep to just not advance. And that was a great play, but I'm just happy to win something today.
A little hardware helps. I completely agree with you.
Yeah.
So first, we all know who won the championship, but the next one is the MVP. And this one goes for the most valuable player throughout the tournament, not just the championship game. It typically does go to a champion player. We are proud to announce this year, through his hustle, through his hard plays, and for the first time ever, co-commissioner Rick Vandenboom getting the MVP this year.
Oh, baby. I'm getting extra carry on for Alaska, baby.
Woo! Rick Lodge had to pay $75, almost the cost of a flight to bring that back to Alaska, but well worth it.
I'll pay every penny, baby. I'll pay every penny.
Rick, what's the feeling? You've been here since the very start, and this is the first time you have brought home either the MVP or the championship trophy.
I've had five great moments in my life. I was born. I got married, I had two kids, and today I won a championship in the MVP, baby.
That's six.
Thank you for putting those in the right order.
There's seven or eight.
And we won't make you rate those.
Yeah, thank you.
Just take your hardware.
Hey, come back here.
And you can go to your team, Rick. We would be honored to present you and your team who were representing our Army branch of our military service. Rick, this is the 2014 Lake Orion Football Tournament of Champions Championship Trophy.
Take a sip, boys, take a sip.
Take a sip from the goblet.
You guys are poor for him right now.
Where is the confetti? Fireworks.
That didn't work.
That got me.
I guarantee this thing's never been watched.
All right.
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
Yeah.
Jeff, you can't get much beer to drink up.
Corey, I'm sleeping on the couch tonight.
Woo. Anyway.
Right. Yeah, anyways, I'd like to again thank everybody for coming out. We had a great fundraising event, a great tournament, and a beautiful day. So thank you all for coming out, and we look forward to next year. And we'd also like to thank Joe Johnson from Orion Network TV. We're looking at you right now, Joe. He's the man behind the mic, taking his time so he can, you know, spread the word on our organization, everything that we're trying to do. So again, thank the Vandenbooms and all of our sponsors and supporters. Our next door neighbors, McConnell's from Vandenboom Field, they lend their yard to us, and we're just very thankful for everybody here.
All of our sponsors, Tim Hollis for providing the sound equipment, everybody
helps out for this
everybody.
Event. And we love all of you for it.
And as we close, as always, God bless America and God bless Wiffle Ball.